Tonight we celebrate the achievements of a selfless, dedicated and determined member of the Australian music industry. I first met this lady when I was 13, just a student of Tamworth High School. She flew all the way from Sydney to hear me sing during my lunch break. It was the start of a really long mentorship that had a hugely positive influence on my career. I was not alone in this experience, as she's touched so many lives over the past 30 years. Dawn Fraser, John Williamson, Benita Mabo, Father Chris Riley, Human Nature, Alan Jones, Angus and Julia Stone. An intriguing and diverse group. What could they possibly have in common? Well, it's our 2012 Ted Albert Award recipient. Our winner this year has devoted her entire working life to developing and nurturing young and often disadvantaged performers. She began as a high school music teacher, working passionately to help young people reach their full creative potential. She helped create and direct the very first school spectacular in 1984 and has been its director for 26 years. It's the largest variety show in the world and continues to this day, showcasing the finest talents in the New South Wales public school system. It features 3,000 performers, an 80-piece symphony orchestra, dancers, bands, soloists, and a 1,000-voice choir. The school spectacular is held at the Sydney Entertainment Centre and is broadcast nationally on ABC television. But the person we honour tonight did not stop there. It was not enough just to give talented young people the opportunity to perform and shine. She wanted to help them build careers in this industry. She went the next step and in 1991 took on artistic directorship of the Talent Development Program, which does remain the most respected and unique music training program in Australia. The program prepares young, gifted performers for music careers in the entertainment industry and actively seeks out opportunities to showcase their talents. The program has given us Angus and Julia Stone, Microwave Jenny, Human Nature, Paulini, John Foreman, Emma Pask, the McClymonts, just to name a few. Not satisfied with success creating opportunities in Australia, our winner negotiated a partnership with the American Society of Composers, Authors and Publishers. As a result, several performers have participated in showcases and workshops in New York and Washington. Her focus is one thing: extraordinary talent, regardless of circumstance, race, or background. Father Chris Riley, founder and director of Youth Off the Streets, said of our winner, "She not only believes our disadvantaged kids have greatness in them, she brings this greatness out." In 1999, she was awarded an Order of Australia Medal. In 2007, she was crowned the Variety Humanitarian of the Year. And last year, she received an Honorary Doctorate of Letters from the University of Western Sydney and was added to the Sydney Entertainment Centre's Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, let's show you some of these achievements.
You know you make me want to shout, kick my hands up, shout, throw my head back, shout, kick my heels up, shout, come on now, shout, get to say you will.
The young performers are all learning from each other and they're all creating their shows together, working together. So it's an incredible way of learning respect for each other, and they love it. Talent Development Project is a really special program that prepares young people from government schools for a career in the entertainment and music industry. It makes them concerned and caring about other people, because in this program they must work together. They perform together, they create together, they socialise together, because it's not a competition. This program is not about competition. This is about being the best that you can possibly be yourself and being extremely proud of who you are. Our performers are brave, and that's the Aussie spirit. You know, it is that thing that they're prepared to take on anything. We teach them disciplines, self-esteem, self-confidence, all of these life skills which they can take into any area of their career or their personal life. Then we teach them about the creativity, the writing of songs, the creating of shows.
Helping create such a fantastic show.
That what I'm saying is true. I wish for you.
The really important thing about talent also is that it is unique. We want them to find who they are and to be very proud of who they are and to tell that story. Go one step further, always try harder, never, ever, ever give up.
Mary, your mantra is to live your dream and never give up. Thank you for the careers that you have touched. Our culture and our industry is all the richer for it. Please join with me in congratulating our very good friend and deserving recipient of the 2012 Ted Albert Memorial Award for outstanding service to Australian music, Mary Lopez.
Thank you so much, and thank you, Felicity, a truly lovely person and a great musician. As Fliss said, I met her when she was 13 and was completely touched then by the extraordinary purity of her voice and sensational diction. Since then, she's become a great songwriter and a broadcaster and a mum. That's fabulous. Good on you, Fliss. And Fliss is part of that wonderful network of TDP graduates, gorgeous people with huge talents, and a lot of you here in the room tonight. Thanks to the wonderful friends here in the music industry and for thinking that I was worthy to receive this honour. Thank you for acceptance of me, who comes from a very different place in the world of music. It's been an absolute privilege to have a career that I've had, and it's wonderful to receive an award for something that I so love. It's especially significant to get this Ted Albert Award because David, his nephew, has been a long-time supporter of the Talent Development Project. We record there, and he's also given us a fabulous grand piano, which we use in our workshops every month. Of course, the most precious people in my life are my family. I'm the youngest of eight kids, grew up in a very small country town. And my daughter and my son, Kate and Andy, and their late father supported me and gave me the love, never ended, to have the career. They shared me with so many other people and they never really made a fuss about it. Thanks, Andy and Kate. And now I have a very loving and patient partner, Rob, who's here tonight also. And thanks, Rob, for giving me time to finish what I started. I've been surrounded by a passionate but very small team in the TDP, and we all know you can't do anything without your team. And those people, Andrew B, Robin Philpott and Kim Lemke, supported by a fantastic board of directors that I have, which contain people like Alan Jones and John Brown, who have worked alongside of me for 25 years. These are the people who are the powerhouse behind the Talent Development Project, the people that make it happen. Our sponsors, who give us the money, the Department of Education and Training, and all of those people who share that same passion. So many of you here tonight guided me. When we started this program, it was about performance, and I got a good talking to fairly quickly by someone that you will all know pretty well here, and that's Fifa Riccobona. So Fifa then guided the TDP into the world of songwriting, and that program is driven by my great career partner here tonight, Andrew B. And it's really important that I let you know about Andrew, because when I stopped doing this program, Andrew B, from Out There Productions and now the musical director for TDP, he'll make sure that it keeps going. Thank you, Andrew, for walking alongside of me in the School Spectacular and the TDP for well over 25 years now. The consultants who give their time freely to this program, because this program is free. So many of them here in this room have helped create this super school for the music industry. After Fifa came along Millie. Millie Petriella came and taught us all about APRA. She believed in the program and guided us and harassed us and got a sponsorship for us so that we were able to keep on working with our songwriters. Simon Moore. Now, you won't believe this, but Simon was a student of mine. He also took me aside. And Simon, my ex-student, became my music industry teacher. Les Gock, he was another one. Marketing guru. He taught us about style and put us in the right direction there. And, of course, from Sony Music, Dennis Handlin, godfather of the recording industry, my mentor, sponsor, and he gave us access to the recording industry. And of course, Emmanuel Candy, always there as the fixer. It was mentioned early though, Michael Kirker from ASCAP New York and LA, who taught me about the ultimate respect for the song. We started this program about singers and instrumentalists. But if we don't have the songs, then there's no point in the singer. So Andrew B and I hope to work much more closely with so many of the publishing groups here in the room tonight, and so we'll be very much looking forward to forming those relationships. This room is full of outstanding, creative people who all love music. Let's keep building on this wonderful music industry with respect for each other and for all musical genres. And let the power of the song be powerful throughout the world. Thank you for loving music, and for all of those people tonight who have won awards and who have shared their incredible gifts with us. Thank you and congratulations. Never, ever, ever give up. Live your dreams. And now for a bit of Shakespeare. Music is the food of love. Let's keep playing on. Thank you very much.